Allahu 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 Allah 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 Allahu 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 Allah
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Before we start, I'm gonna first of all I would like to greet in regard to the Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. You know, it's not a privilege to stand here and then speak to you. Actually, I doesn't deserve to stand in front of you and then spoke to you a couple of words. But it has been decided that I have to come to that specific event that's going to happen in the madrasa. Then that's why I'm here. I'm not going to take much time off you today, because this opportunity that these event had been provided me. And it's kind of a event which I normally used to come, but this is a privilege that I decided to come down. Even the people used to have gathering all over the world, but the thing is, this privilege gonna destroy in this world. But if there is a gathering, it is mentioned in a hadith, the nearest meaning, if the persons are gathered all over the world, anywhere, and they are started to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they are doing the zikr, as well as sending the darud salam, that means the blessings of blessing on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is mentioned in a hadith that the angels wanna descend and then cover the gathering. That means we are staying here, and then we are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Along with that, we are sending the salam and darud towards Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this kind of gathering today that we are here, we can't see with our naked eye, but believe me, this kind of gathering had been covered up by the angels. These gatherings had been covered up by the angels at the moment, but we can't see, right? You know, I was very much obliged, actually, when I saw the students of this madrasa. They came down to the stage and they performed very well. I really appreciate that, because you are in a totally different platform now, and it's totally different kind of scenario you guys are facing at the moment, okay? But even though in this kind of situation, you are speaking fluently and then trying to develop yourself, that make me happy. Yeah, that made me happy, believe me, that made me happy as well, that in the society, in the platform that you guys are staying at the moment, you are trying your level best to be a number one. Yeah, the Islam also asks us to be in the first position. We are not saying that we have to be like only on the specific platform we have to be in the first, like in the deen we have to first, but in dunya we have to on the last. No, we have to be first in the deen as well, as well as we have to be first in the dunya as well. Yeah, most of the philosophers, most of the, you know, the scientists, most of the mathematicians, these belongs to the Islamic background, but the people, they had been covered up, like most of the scientists had been from the different background, but the Muslim majority countries, they develop this kind of intellect that the people who belong to the Muslim community, and they are raising and they are working to develop the society in terms of the, you know, research, in terms of the development, in terms of the road and development, that means kind of development towards the specific heights, right? And one more thing I would like to say, you know, whatever we do in this world, it's not gonna stay here, it's gonna come back with us. Everybody knows that there are two angels on to the right and to the left. Everybody, I'm standing here, you guys are sitting here, and this respected person are sitting here, but we can't see, like the two angels are onto the right and one is onto the left. Do you know what does we call them? Do you know what does the angels that we call them on, who are staying on our shoulders, onto the right, kiraman, onto the left, katibin, yeah? What these guys are doing? these guys had been appointed, whatever the work that we are doing, they're gonna write it down. They're gonna write it down. The guy who is unto the right, he's gonna take the good deeds and then he write it down. And the guy who is unto the left shoulder, he's writing the sins. That means the bad deeds. If we are doing the good deeds, then it's gonna be written straight away. If you are doing any kind of bad deed, this angel gonna ask this angel, that means who is on the right, who is appointed to write the good deeds, he's kind of an amir, who is a kind of a senior to him. Before his, without his permission, this guy can't write the sin. First of all, once we do any kind of sin, he will ask whether I'm gonna write it down his sin. It's the guy who's on to the right, he say, wait for a moment. Maybe he's gonna do tawbah. Maybe he's gonna do tawbah, then you won't need to write it down. Then he can wait for further, like 1 hour or 2 hours, sometimes 4 hours. Maybe sometimes it has been mentioned that from one namaz to another namaz, one salah to another salah, there is a during that duration, if the person did tawbah, the sins that we had done, it will be not written. It will be eliminated. Why I'm saying this? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so much merciful. If the person, if the, you know, the angel on to the right, he might have rights. If you do any kind of good deed, even though you do any kind of intention in your hand, you know, in your mind, that I'm gonna go for the prayer, whether I'm gonna go for the Islamic kind of, you know, speech. If you are just making the intention, what's gonna happen? This guy write it down straight away. But if someone is decided to do any kind of sin, he just decided in his mind, but it won't be written. But if a person decided to do a good thing, good deed, he just decided in his mind that I'm gonna do it, then the, you know, the virtue will be written straight away. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful upon us. That's why these things are had been mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay, I'm gonna start some things that I would like to discuss today. Like, first of all, you guys are staying here for a long time. Like, you guys are studying here. Someone is doing their alimiyat. Yeah, I believe that it's gonna be for 4 years. And somebody are doing the diploma courses, right? It's gonna be last for 12 months, like 1 year. But now, once you get together, there will be some clashes between the two persons. It's natural, yeah? You will have some kind of clashes between your friends and between your colleagues and between your classmates or someone. But end of the day, we have to clean our hearts. End of the day, we have to clean our hearts. How it's gonna be possible? Yeah, it is mentioned in a hadith. The nearest meaning I heard from the elders, like once upon a time, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting with his companions, and what do we call the companions actually? What do we call companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Sahaba. Yeah, yes, he was sitting with his companions at the time. Just before that, he mentioned that, like, one person gonna join you who is a heavenly person. Who is a heavenly person? The people wonder who gonna come and join this group. Then they saw one person coming, come here, that means come to that specific group and joined. And the water was dripping from his beard. He just done the wazu. And then he come into that group and sat with this group. All the people, all the sahaba, all the companions saw him sitting. He's coming into the group and then sit there. Then matters over, the ban had been took place and somebody has left. After the meeting, on the same occasion, like on the second day, then again Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one person who is a heavenly person, jo jannati hai, he gonna come down to you and he gonna join you. Then again the people started to stare, who gonna join us? Then again the same person came to the group with the dripping the water dripping beard. He just done the wazu, the water is dripping from his beard, and then he come to the specific inner group and joined the specific group. The sahaba was very much happy. This is the same guy that we saw yesterday. On the third day as well, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was having the gathering with that specific, you know, the group. Again he said the one person gonna come down to you, he's a heavenly person, gonna join you. Then on the third day as well, the same person come to that specific group and join them. The people was very happy that he's the same guy, he's a jannati. Yeah, he's a person who is a heavenly. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if the Prophet is said, it's gonna be true. It's gonna be true. Then what happened? One among the companion of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he decided to go with this guy. and ask him or whether he's gonna find out what exactly the virtue that this guy possess. That means what kind of deed he has done. On that basis, Prophet ﷺ had given them the virtue of a heavenly person, Jannati. Yeah, then he decided to come go with this guy and then find out what exactly it is. Then what happened at the end of that meeting, this person approached this guy and then the Sahabi and said, I'm gonna stay with you, okay? I'm like a host to you, I'm gonna stay with you. And he said, okay, aap mera mehman, if you want to become a host, you are welcome. You come to my house and then stay with me. Then what happened? He became the guest. Yeah. On the first day, he was watching all his works. He used to pray the normal namaz. He used to wake up in the early morning. He used to do tahajjud. He used to do the fajr salah, zuhr salah, asr, maghrib, isha. Nothing unusual. He didn't say any kind of specific work, any kind of a specific good deed that he realized that it's gonna make a difference. On the first day, he couldn't find any kind of difference. On the second day, couldn't find the same, couldn't find any kind of difference. He's doing the normal deeds. Yeah, he was doing Fajr Salat before the Tahajjud, Fajr, Zuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, 5 times Salah, and he used to zikr. He used to do not heavy zikr, just as normal zikr, and he used to do. He used to read the Quran as has been on a specific normal way. On the third day as well, he couldn't find anything about this guy. What the specific deed that he had done, on that basis, the Prophet ﷺ exclaimed to him that he's gonna be a Jannati, he's gonna be a heavenly person. On the third day, because if a person is going to be a guest of someone, he won't be allowed for more than 3 days to stay, according to the hadith, yeah, according to fatwa. On the third day, he couldn't find any kind of specific deed. On the third day, he fed up, and at the end, he said, I became your guest only to find out what the specific deed that you are doing, on which basis the Prophet ﷺ has said to you, you're a heavenly person. That's the solely and the holy intention of mine, to find out what kind of virtue do you have. On that basis, Prophet ﷺ said, you are a heavenly person. And that person said, I doesn't do any kind of special deeds. I'm just a normal person. I do your normal deeds. He said, no, there will be a something different. That's where the Prophet ﷺ has said, you are a heavenly person. And he said, maybe, I don't know, but one thing I used to do on a daily basis. Say what? Once I go to the bed for the sleep in the night, I do wazu, and do a little bit of zikr. And before I go sleep, before I close my eyes, I speak to my heart that in this, you know, from morning till evening, the person who have hurt me, I forgive them. The persons who have hurt me, I forgive them. I don't keep any kind of distractions in my mind. Maybe that's the thing that the Prophet ﷺ has said. Then the Sahabi, the companion who joined him as a guest, he said, this is the thing. That you are cleaning your hearts on a daily basis. You are not keeping any kind of kaji, any kind of distraction in your heart. That's the basic thing. That's why the Prophet ﷺ has said, you're a heavenly person. In the same way, why I'm telling you this kind of story to you? Because you guys are staying here for a couple of years, and you're gonna stay here for the long time. After that, you will be divided. What I'm trying to say, on a daily basis, you will have some kind of clashes between your colleagues, your classmates or someone, but at the end of the day, you have to clean your hearts. You don't have to keep anything in your hearts. It has to be clean. It has to be clean as a water. Okay, that's my suggestion and a kindly request to go with that. And then, some more thing I would like to say. You know, just a couple of days before, one of my friend who was used to be in the neighbor country, which country I'm talking about? Anyone? Yeah, that's the one, yeah? The guy who is in at the moment neighbor country, he shared a story of his country. When I was in UK, then I had been in good contact with this guy who was in Karachi at the time. Then he shared one story. Yeah, in the school of the neighbor country, they mentioned, the teacher asked the students to bring the sand of heaven. On the next day, she had given the project that the student has to bring the sand of heaven for the next class. the people, the students wonder how they're gonna get the sand of heaven. On the second day, nobody have bought any kind of sand, but one student from the class, he bought a small bowl of sand, and he said, "This is the sand of heaven." And the teacher asked, "How did you clarify that? How do you justify that this sand belongs to the heaven?" He said, "This is the sand beneath the knee of my mother." Got it? "This is the sand beneath the feet of my mother, and the sand I take it up in the bowl and take it to you." He said, "Wow, you got the point. You got the point, because it is mentioned in a hadith in the speeches. One of the students had mentioned that the heaven had been situated beneath the feet of the mother. Yeah, onto the hadith basis, the student said, "This stands beneath my feet of my mother. This belongs to the heavenly one." Yeah, this is the fact, guys. This is the fact that we have to trust. What does the iman is? Iman is nothing but the trust. How you trust? It depends how you trust. On the day of Qiyamah, I don't want to bore you enough. I'm gonna finish. Just listen to me, please. Yeah, on the day of Qiyamah, Allah doesn't count the good deeds and the bad deeds. In the angels who have decided to check your deeds, yeah, they're not gonna count our deed. How many good deeds we had done, how many namazes have been prayed, and how many, fastings we had done. Nobody gonna check it. There nobody gonna count it. But on the day of Qiyamah, it will be weighted. Our deeds will be weighted. That means there will be a balance, kind of by a balance, yeah. In a plate, there will be a good deeds, and to the second plate, there will be bad deeds. On the day of Qiyamah, if a person, it is mentioned Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, yeah, مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرٍ يَرَى. Yeah, whatever you do, yeah, whatever, if you are doing a small deed, like it's having a weight of your hair, yeah, if it is having the weight of your hair, it's gonna show how much milligrams it's gonna have. In the same way, that kind of accuracy, the weight, the balance have. On the day of Qiyamah, our good deeds will be on the right side, on the right plate, and the bad deeds gonna be onto the left plate. On the day of Qiyamah, our amal, our deed will be weighted. They are not counted, but they will be weighted. Yeah, and how the weight signifies? The weight gonna be signified by your iman, by our iman. That means how much we trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how much trust in namaz, how much trust we do zikr, how much we trust in the name of the Quran, reciting the Quran, how much trust, how much iman does we possess, that kind of weightage gonna come to the specific amal. Got it? Right. And some more thing I would like to say, and then before I go to conclusion, right? And it is mentioned during the speeches, some of the students brilliantly said, and they performed very well. I really appreciate that these guys have put their effort into that specific kind of event, even though they doesn't belong to this specific category, okay? They doesn't belong to specific environment, even though they tried and they performed very well, and they decided to perform the dialect of the specific English, and they tried to copy the accent as well. I really appreciate that. Okay, one more thing I would like to say. Among the speeches, it is mentioned that the woman is like a diamond. Yeah? Like, what we gonna do? If you are having a diamond, whether you're gonna keep it on the table, or whether you're gonna keep it on the books, or whether you're gonna keep it in your compass, which you possess the pencil and the pen, if you have the diamond, whether you're gonna keep it in your compass? No. Where you gonna keep it? You're gonna keep it in your chest. That means in the house, in your bureau, or yeah, like any kind of big box, wooden box, or the metal box, you're gonna hide it. If you're having the diamond, you're gonna hide it. You won't disclose it to the normal people. Yeah. In the same way, in Islam, it is taught that every woman is treated as a diamond. Every woman is treated as a diamond. That's why we covered it up. That means Islam teaches that the girls have to come out to study, to perform, to service, to do the service. Even though they are coming out, but they are covered with the hijab. Why? Because they are the diamonds. As we show the diamonds who we love, who we like, like our mother, our brother, our sister, if they are married to their husbands, they're going to show the diamonds only. Yeah. In the same way, Islam teaches us, if you are like a real diamond, you have to cover it up. If you are covering up, then you are like a precious stone, which is called as a diamond. Okay, before we conclude, I'm just going to say that you guys are staying in the madrasa for a couple of months, then you will be leaving. Yeah. Then once you leave, decide in your life that you won't gonna lose a single namaz. Yeah, namaz is, you know, the salat is the foremost important thing after the iman. On the day of qiyamah, Allah doesn't check how many deeds that you have done. Before he asks, he will check your namaz only. He will check the namaz only. It is mentioned in a hadith, the nearest meaning, on the day of qiyamah, each and every person's among the good deeds, only namaz will be checked. Only, first of all, the namaz will be checked. If the first namaz is perfect, then he will be decided that he is going to the Jannah. And the book of deed, what do we call it? Naam-e Amal. Yeah? The book of deeds is going to be given into the right hand. And this kind of a thing is called as a certificate. This guy or this lady or this girl is going to Jannah. Yeah? That means if you are praying the five times namaz, it is mentioned in a hadith, the nearest meaning, that on the day of Qiyamah, your good deed, the book of deeds, gonna be given onto your right hand. Right? How are they gonna conclude? First of all, they check our Faraz namaz. First of all, they're gonna check our Faraz namaz. If it is perfect, the rest of the amal are perfect. If there is any kind of deficiency, the rest of the amal are also having the deficiency. For example, normally most of us, you guys used to cook the rice in the house. Yeah. Once after certain time, you won't check all the rice, like whether it has been cooked or not. You won't check it. What are you gonna do? You just take one or two grains out. You take one or two grains out and then check it. If it is done, if the rice is done, the two grains are done, the rest of the rice is done. Got it? In the same way, on the day of Qiyamah, Allah doesn't check all the amals. First of all, he go with the first namaz. If it is perfect, then the job is done. The job is done that you are going to Jannah. If it is there is any kind of deficiency in the Faraz namaz, then it will be fulfilled with the Nawafil. It will be fulfilled with the Nawafil. That's the thing that Allah Ta'ala had decided to give the namaz kind of, you know, this is one kind of a prize, the trophy that it has been given by the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Yeah, on the day, on the night, as like the Miraj, he had been ascended from the earth to sky. And then once he met to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ta'ala had given him like 50 namazes on a daily basis. But due to our deficiency, due to our less effort, due to our less age, like 70 to 80 years on an average basis, yeah, we had been declined to 5 times. Earlier it had decided to offer us 50 times namaz on a daily basis. But we are weak, that's why it has been cut down from 50 to 5 times. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the nearest meaning, if a person offers 5 times salah, he will be awarded for the 50 times salah. Yeah, that's the thing. Allah Ta'ala is so much merciful that he didn't decide to cut the, even though the namaz had been cut down to 50 to 5, but Allah Ta'ala didn't cut down the virtue. The virtue will be the same. The 5 times, you will get the reward of 50 namaz. Yeah, hope whatever I had said, Allah make me do amal on it, and let you do the amal, whatever I had said, and Allah Ta'ala accept this opportunity, and Allah Ta'ala accept this kind of effort, the people who are sitting on to my left, they are the holy people, yeah, and they have given their lives to this kind of effort. Yeah, I really appreciate that, and also looking forward to become one day like them, because today we are chasing dunya, me myself chasing dunya, but what's gonna happen end of the day, we're gonna lose. As we have came from the womb of mother in this dunya empty-handed, in the same way we are going to enter into the qabr with the empty-handed. Yeah, nobody has claimed anything, even though it is mentioned Sikandar-e-Azam, who was the foremost ruler of the world, more than half the world. Yeah, once he died, he said to his the followers to keep the hands outside the janaza. That means the thing that used to carry his dead body, the cot which used to carry his dead body. He said, he asked, once my dead body is going to the grave, keep both the hands outside the grave, outside the cot. The people asked, why did you giving such kind of strange will? He said, most of the people gonna come to know, because even though I am the Sikandar of Sikandar Azam, but I am going empty-handed. Yeah, in the same way, guys, we have came into this world by the womb of the mother empty-handed, but we are going into the in the qabr, in the grave, empty-handed. But the things that we're gonna carry are the deeds, our good deeds and the bad deeds. It depends how much deed we're gonna do. Okay, may Allah Ta'ala accept this effort and then really appreciate the work that has been done so far. Jazakallah.